People and companies are pouring hundreds of millions of dollars into the vision of the metaverse.
Made up of persistent, shared 3D virtual
spaces.
The
metaverse. It's supposed to be the next dimension of the internet.
The metaverse.
And we call this the metaverse.
From the unceasing scope of social media to everyday television news, the metaverse has been frequenting tables of discussion as the next internet revolution. News of the biggest companies worldwide have loudly expressed their interest in shifting to this new technology. Project partnerships among major international brands tell us there might just be great opportunities ahead.
The term was first coined in this Neil Stephenson 1992 novel. It's about human beings that we can be programmable avatars and how we interact with each other using our avatars. And since then, we have been working a lot, apart from avatars, also on the 3D virtual space that this novel has described. It's really exciting to us.
MARKETECH APAC Reels is here to talk about the metaverse. This will be a three-part series where we feature thought leaders and metaverse experts to share their knowledge on the next dimension of the internet and what steps brands need to take in order to thrive in this emerging technology. In this episode, we will dive into the birth of the metaverse. So how can the metaverse be the next big thing for your business and brand? Virtual reality and augmented reality have been on the rise for years now. They're nothing new. As a matter of fact, these recent developments in technology have lived up to its reputation of accelerating change. And that change wasn't up for debate until the pandemic.
China has identified the cause of the
mysterious new virus.
Coronavirus.
Suddenly, we didn't have human interactions. People craved to connect with others, to be in the moment, to be in a physical space. The pandemic forced us into isolation. The only lively moments that we had with people in meetings is now replaced by awkward silence. So even after all the advancements, we saw technology in its current limits.
Okay, when you first heard the term metaverse, what do you think? You think, okay, it's kind of a completely new cool world with a whole new things with magic and everything, right? So that thing is missing. We are lacking immersive experience now.
This is where the metaverse comes in. A space for immersive and interactive experience that seek to overcome the limitations of existing technology.
The metaverse will provide us with limitless opportunities for us to customize our avatars, and we can actually use those avatars to engage with different organizations, individuals. So this is why the metaverse is causing so much excitement. The decentralized nature of the metaverse is set to change people's life because of the endless new opportunities it provides to individuals and brands. Hence, marketers will have a lot more opportunities there.
Web 1 is considered the earliest version of the internet. Some call it the read-only web. Basically, users could only access information in text format and read. No images, no videos, no one else. Just you and limited information. Then Web 2 came along and gave users the ability to do more. Through social media networking sites, blogs, and wikis, now we experience the internet as mostly user-generated content. You can view and share text, images, or videos all in one click. Now with Web 2.0, users have unlimited access to different kinds of unlimited content. So what more is there?
So that will lead us to a topic, which is Web3. I would say that's the next generation or evolution of internet.
In current time, Web 3.0 is defined as an enhanced, immersive, and highly interactive internet, which will allow its users to appear as avatars living in virtual 3D spaces.
Just like how we have evolved from Web 1 to Web 2, and right now Web 3, to us, the metaverse is just another way for people to connect with each other.
As the laying foundation of the metaverse, Web 3.0 will pride itself on the concept of decentralized technology and individual ownership.
I think the biggest distinction between the internet of today and the next evolution is the decentralization nature of Web3. The decentralization within the metaverse would enable digital assets to be communally owned, free flowing, transparently traceable, and protected protected from unauthorized access using the advanced cryptography.
With the metaverse currently holding its title as the future internet, many are looking into what has been on the rise to become its pillars. In any existing modern-day world is a running economy, and as observed from various recent discussions, the metaverse offers enormous opportunities for monetization. Much like in video games where players can buy and sell goods with in-game money, a similar system is bound to be implemented through NFTs.
Gaming is the most recognized platform to the metaverse where players have long been able to purchase virtual accessories for their avatars.
Using NFTs, people can and are purchasing virtual goods the same way we do in the real world, from a cute handbag to a plot of land in the metaverse.
Basically, how we see NFTs as like a digital ownership of a particular asset. If you have a digital asset, and you have to basically sell the ownership on that.
Now, if you haven't heard, NFT stands for non-fungible token.
Anything that's unique and that cannot be replicated.
This is because each NFT bears a digital signature that makes it impossible to be exchanged for or to be equal to one another, hence non-fungible.
If you put that thing on a blockchain with the help of a token, it's a completely unique token which has its own unique identity. Now you are basically transferring the ownership of a particular thing by associating that particular thing with this unique NFT.
NFTs exist on a blockchain, which is an immutable database storage that is difficult to cheat, hack, or alter.
Blockchain is kind of a distributed ledger, kind of a way to transfer information from one side to another in a more decentralized way.
With blockchain technology, users will be able to securely own, buy and sell digital goods, not just in the real world, but also in virtual spaces. Many experts predict blockchain to be the backbone of the metaverse.
It's built on blockchain, and blockchain is not biased. It's completely distributed and it's completely decentralized. And I think blockchain gives equal opportunity.
As more and more people anticipate an NFT-powered metaverse, things continue to get even more exciting as we witness developments of growing immersive spaces. The collision of augmented reality and virtual reality in the metaverse promises users the ability to connect themselves even more closely with positive experiences.
A lot of interconnected digital spaces where users can interact. There are endless ways for brands and marketers to use those spaces to do things they cannot do in the physical world. So I think it's important to notice that creating new experiences with those spaces will be key for marketers looking to target Generation Z.
Seeing as we are still in its early stages, it's best to keep in mind that there is much to explore.
If let's say we are talking about the novel definitions, we are definitely not yet there. Some say that it may take another 5 to 10 years. Some say that it will take more than 10 years to reach this North Star vision.
With the development of the web and the pillars that upholds this technology, the metaverse opens doors for brands and marketers to create unique experience for consumers. The metaverse allows for limitless possibilities within its virtual ecospace. Though some concerns and questions still remain. How can this technology revolutionize current working cultures? As marketers, how can we maximize the potential of the metaverse? Can small business also thrive in the metaverse? And what challenges can we expect in this limitless space? Now that we have talked about everything you need to know about the metaverse and its birth, tune in for the next episode of this series where we will expand the pillars of the metaverse.